Everybody, Dr. Mark Charles, Fertility CARE, the IVF Center. Happy Monday. Sorry we're a little bit late here on the East Coast and had some patients going through, so we had to delay our video. Hope you had a great weekend. The weather has been gorgeous here in Orlando. I know it won't last, but it's good for now. So the topic for today, endometriosis or endometritis, they're not the same. Endometriosis is a very common condition that is quite debilitating for patients when it becomes severe. So endometriosis, a little bit of the pathophysiology. The lining of the uterus sheds out through a woman on a monthly basis. But think about if you had a water balloon with two openings, right? So when you squeeze the inside, water's gonna go out that way and then also the other way. That's what happens with the uterus. When the uterus contracts to shed the lining each month, most of the lining sheds forward. But through smaller opening to the tubes, because the cervix is wider, so that gets most of the blood, the lesser path gets blood flow as well. So the body usually just resorbs that blood. In about 10 to 15% of the population, that lining of the uterus, which is the glands and the stroma of the lining, implant. Most commonly the ovary, but it could be the fallopian tubes, it could be the lining of the uterus, it could be the bowel, anywhere in the body. So endometriosis is exactly that. Normal lining of the uterus, anywhere else it's not supposed to be. 10 to 15% of women have that. About 40% of infertility patients have endometriosis, and about 40% of endometriosis patients have infertility. So is it worth seeking? No. In other words, the only way to diagnose this is a laparoscopy, a one-day surgery, okay? Unless the ovary on ultrasound looks really classic for endometriosis, but typically laparoscopy. So we don't do a laparoscopy, nor is it recommended when the fallopian tubes are open, the ultrasound is normal, and the woman is not complaining of symptoms of endometriosis, whereas severe painful periods, painful intercourse, painful bowel movements, painful urination, all those type of things can happen. So that's endometriosis. There are four stages, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1 and 2 are not really proven to be associated with infertility. 3 and 4, yes. And those are situations that benefit from surgery, more 3 than stage 4. Is it affecting IVF? In other words, do you need a laparoscopy to take care of endometriosis before IVF? The answer is no, not definitively been shown. There may be a slight decrease though with IVF in patients with endometriosis, okay? So could you have endometriosis when you come to see me? Yes. Is it worth going immediately to laparoscopy? No. There are some doctors that are telling patients they need a laparoscopy because there's fluid inside their pelvis. Not true at all. Absolutely nothing to substantiate that, okay? So once again, normal ultrasound, normal HSG for the tube or patency, and no significant pelvic pain does not require a laparoscopy for fertility treatment. Let's switch over to endometritis. Endometritis is a chronic, well, it could be two ways. I mean, you could have an acute infection, that's acute endometritis, and that needs antibiotics because that could be serious if it does not get treated. It could result in tubal ovarian abscess and severe scarring and even septicemia. I mean, that can get really bad. That's pelvic inflammatory disease. When we do an endometrial biopsy for patients with recurrent miscarriage or recurrent implantation failure with IVF, what we're looking for is something called chronic endometritis. This is not an infection. It's an inflammation, a change of cells of the lining of the uterus, particularly the increase in something called plasma cells. And if there's more than 5 plasma cells per high power field of the microscope, we make that diagnosis. We treat it with antibiotics, and then we repeat the biopsy we treat for antibiotics about 2 weeks, so there after that. If the endometritis is gone, then we conceive. If it's not gone, then we would treat with antibiotics again, a different regimen. So it's not life-threatening, and you probably don't even know you have it. Is there an association with endometritis and endometriosis? I've seen some investigators starting to look at that, but nothing at all evidence yet. So that's the difference. Endometriosis is not endometritis and vice versa, and we treat them differently. Hope this was helpful. Have an awesome week, and we will see you next week. Take care.